风烟俱静，天山共色，从流飘荡，任意东西。自富阳至桐庐一百许里，奇山异水，天下独绝。如果要给富春江贴一个标签的话，我想应该用"隐逸"这两个字。南朝梁代文学家吴钧来到这里，给他的好朋友朱元思写信说："这里奇山异水，天下独绝，让他望风栖心，流连忘返。" 元代的画家黄公望来到这里隐居，用了三年时间，给他的好朋友吴用师画了那幅千古流传的《富春山居图》。是什么在感召着一代又一代的文人隐士来到这里打卡隐居？是这奇山异水，天下独绝吗？我想，应该是2000年前在这里隐居的那位东汉名士颜子陵。
颜子陵那位他是会稽。 余姚人，也就是现在的宁波余姚四人，然后他在长安念书的时候，认识了刘秀。其实他们两个人呢，应该是属于忘年交。后来颜子陵辅助刘秀打败了这个王莽，他也想让颜子陵担任一个重要的职务高官，但是颜子陵呢？ 到了一个山东一带，五星埋名，劈了羊球在那儿垂钓。刘秀就请了他三次，就相当于三顾茅庐，他才去来到了洛阳。有一天，刘秀跟颜子陵两个人同床而卧，相谈甚欢。颜子陵就把脚搁在光武帝的肚子上，所以第二天管星象的马上来禀报。 说有克星犯玉座圣解，结果刘秀笑着说："他说没事，这是我跟老朋友颜子陵同床而卧罢了。"In
his letter to Yanzilin, Emperor Guangwu said, "An outstanding emperor would have unconstrained ministers. He knew very well that to be a virtuous emperor, he had to allow there were distinguished men who did not obey him." So after several failed invitations, he politely sent Yanzilin off to Fuchun River. You may think that this story isn't complicated, for there are many hermits in Chinese history. However, all the lands and human belong to the emperor then. When we look at Yan's Confuciousness and the emperor's generosity together, such stories are few and far between.
Yanzilin and Guangwu, he has two dialogues.
不能成先生之高，非先生不能成光武之大。
A thousand years after Yanzilin's death, Fan Zhongyan was relegated to Tonglu. He used the state treasury firstly to build a shrine for Yanzilin and wrote this famous record of Mr. Yan's ancestral hall. You can feel his admiration for Yanzilin between the lines.
云山苍苍，江水泱泱，先生之风，山高水长。这是在《祠堂记》最后，范仲淹写给颜子陵的颂歌。现在很多人喜欢把这16个字送给自己的老师，但殊不知，范仲淹如此推崇颜子陵，背后还有更加深刻的原因。对于颜子陵这样一个人物，能够为他修祠作祭，从他的角度，他认为颜先生的这种风节风骨。 是可以使贪腐廉，懦夫劣，是有大功于明教，就是让有贪心的人能够变得清廉起来，胆小的人能够变得挺立起来，勇敢起来。Fan
went to the northwest to resist Western Xia Dynasty, then returned to the court. When the Qingli New Deal failed, he went to the village. 12 years after he left Tonglu, he wrote Yueyang Tower. I'm concerned with people while serving the emperor and worried about emperor while dedicating among the people. His sense to life had entered a different realm from Yanzilin's. He had achieved a sublime personality that future generations will look up to.
所以每当来到颜子陵钓台，大家更感兴趣的可能是光武帝和颜子陵的故事。但是，当放眼这泱泱江水， 苍苍云山，我们是否更可以遐想，在1000年前，范仲淹在这山水之间，和颜子陵进行的心灵对话。